There are billions of planets in the universe, and since humankind evolved, we've only lived on Earth. But now scientists have discovered not one, but over 20 planets that can accommodate human life. Is there life outside of Earth? Like every other planet, our beloved Earth is thought to have been birthed over 4 billion years ago, so it's only expected that it'll age and no longer be as healthy as it was as a young planet. Moreover, human activities are altering our climate and vegetation, hence the search for other habitable planets. For years, Mars was our only alternative to Earth, and of course, the red planet has always warned us that it didn't want humans there and toughened its terrain. But in a turn of events, NASA is giving us hope that there are 24 other planets that can be habitable, and one of the most exciting things about these newly discovered exoplanets is that they are 100 light years or more away from Earth, making them harder to access and study. One example of such a planet is Kepler-186f, located in the Cygnus constellation and about 500 light years from Earth. The discovery of these exoplanets is a breakthrough in astrobiology and could have a huge impact on our understanding of the potential for life in the universe. It also opens the door for future exploration and study of these worlds in search of life beyond our planet. In the search for habitable planets, astronomers have long resorted to four habitability criteria. These habitability criteria did not conclude that life was present on these planets, but that life could survive on the planets that have the habitability criteria. The criteria used for analyzing the habitability of up to 4,500 exoplanets were the planet's needs to have G stars with short lifespans of less than 10 billion years, which provides similar conditions as available with our Sun for Earth, the same as those of systems with K-dwarf stars. The next criterion is that the planet needs to be 10% or larger than Earth, which means it will potentially have more land than Earth. More land also means that the planet will be able to keep its interior heating within for much longer. This means that the planet will potentially have stronger gravity for retaining its atmosphere for a longer time. Another criterion considered for habitability was the presence of water on the planet. This is one of the most important criteria. The last criterion is that of the planet's surface temperature, which needs to be more than 5 degrees Celsius in relation to what is obtainable on Earth. This temperature is considered to be better for life. Scientists identified these planets to be located within their star's habitable zone, which means that the temperatures on the surface of these planets are just right for liquid water to exist. This is a crucial requirement for life as we know it. Each of the newly discovered exoplanets is located within the habitable zone of their host star and has characteristics that make each of them a strong candidate for potentially supporting life. But the downside is that many of them are very far away from Earth. We'll look at KOI 5715.01 first. KOI 5715.01 is located in the Cygnus constellation and is about 3,000 light years away from Earth. It was discovered by the Kepler Space Telescope. It is a Jupiter-sized gas giant that orbits its star at a distance of about 0.5 astronomical units. But the most exciting thing about KOI 5715.01 is that it is located in the habitable zone of its star, where temperatures are just right for liquid water to exist on its surface. This means it has the potential to support life as we know it. KOI 5715.01 is a super-Earth, meaning that it is larger than our planet. TOI 4306b. TOI 4306b lies in its star's habitable zone and was discovered by the Transiting Exoplanet Survey satellite. It is almost the size of Earth, which means it could have a stronger gravitational pull and potentially retain an atmosphere. TOI 4306b is about 100 light years away from Earth. Speculoos 2c is located in the constellation of Aquarius and is about 100 light years away from Earth. Speculoos 2c orbits its star every 8.4 days and is also tidally locked, which means that one side is always day and the other is always night. Despite these changes and conditions, scientists believe it is the second most habitable planet discovered outside our solar system, behind TRAPPIST-1e, and may yet contain liquid water on its surface. GJ-357d. GJ-357d's proximity to Earth makes it a prime target for follow-up studies, as scientists hope to learn more about the potential for life on this exoplanet. The planet is about 1,150 light-years away from Earth and is slightly larger, with a mass of about 6.1 Earth masses. It orbits its host star at a distance of about 0.14 astronomical units and takes about 55.7 days to complete one orbit. The planet is located within the star's habitable zone, which means that it is at the right distance from the star for liquid water to exist on its surface. However, it is unknown if the planet has an atmosphere or is rocky or gaseous in nature. Kepler-1126b. Kepler-1126b orbits a star outside of our solar system. It was discovered by NASA's Kepler Space Telescope in 2016 and is considered a super-Earth due to its size and mass, which is slightly larger and heavier than Earth. The planet orbits a red dwarf star called Kepler-1126 and is located about 2,072.6 light-years away from our solar system in the constellation Cygnus. It is one of the most promising exoplanets discovered, with scientists eagerly awaiting the opportunity to study it in a bit more detail. GJ-357b. Next is GJ-357b. That is an exoplanet that orbits a red dwarf star located 31 light-years away from our solar system and lies in the constellation Hydra. It was first discovered by Tess in 2019 and is about three times the size of Earth, with a surface temperature of around 550 degrees Fahrenheit. Scientists believe that GJ-357b could have a rocky surface and a liquid water ocean. This is because the planet is located within its star's habitable zone, which means that it receives the right amount of energy to support life. Next is GJ-357c, an exoplanet that orbits the same red dwarf star as GJ-357b. It is about four times the size of Earth and has a surface temperature of around 400 degrees Fahrenheit. GJ-357c is farther away from its star than GJ-357b, which means that it receives less energy and is less likely to be habitable. However, scientists believe that the planet could still potentially have a rocky surface and a liquid water ocean. It is about 4.2 times the size of Earth and has a mass of about 8.6 times that of Earth. Next is Kepler-69c. This lies 2,700 light-years away in the constellation Cygnus and is about 2.7 times the size of Earth, with a surface temperature of around 700 degrees Fahrenheit. Kepler-69c is located within the habitable zone of its star, which means that it receives the right amount of energy to support life. But scientists believe that the planet could have a rocky surface and a liquid water ocean. Kepler-186f. This is about the size of Earth, but its mass, composition, and density remain unknown. The exoplanet orbits its star once every 130 days and receives one-third the energy from the Sun that the Earth does, putting it on the outskirts of the habitable zone. If you could stand on Kepler-186f's surface during high noon, the brightness of the star would be as brilliant as our Sun is roughly an hour before nightfall on Earth. It is located in the constellation Cygnus, around 500 light-years from Earth in the Kepler-186 system. TOI-1452b. Another identified habitable planet is TOI-1452b, an exoplanet that orbits a star located 1,200 light-years away in the constellation Ophiuchus. The planet is about 2.5 times the size of Earth and has a surface temperature of around 500 degrees Fahrenheit. TOI-1452b is a hot Jupiter-type planet, a large gas giant that orbits very close to its host star. Studying exoplanets like TOI-1452b can provide insight into the diversity of planetary systems and the processes that shape them. Several other planets have been identified to have habitability by astronomers, and many more may be discovered with advancement in space technology. More information and discovery also can be made with such advancement in space technology on the already identified habitable planets. Professor Dirk Schultz-Makuk, one of the lead researchers, has promised that future telescopes will be able to have an even better view and make more revelations about these planets. He also said that when better telescopes are built, the focus will be on certain planets that have the most promising conditions for complex life, as we have on Earth, or even better.